Today I'm going to be walking through the configuration required to run Jest unit tests within an AEM build. This is to ensure that where we do have tests, that they're passing, and when they don't pass, it actually breaks the build. To download the referenced repository with the sandbox code, please refer to the link in the blog post. With that said, let's dig in. As you can see, we're using the Maven archetype with a UI front-end module for this example. Within the UI front-end module, we have created a test directory where all of our tests will be housed. As you can see, the sandbox test.ts and sandbox fixture.ts. Alongside with this, we have the setup test.ts file. And this ensures that before each of the tests are run, the modules that we've required are reset, so we get a fresh version of the required modules each time a new test is run. This is to avoid any issues with caching of stale modules. So this setup test.ts file is referred to within the Jest config.js, as you can see, setup files after env, and this will make sure anything that we have in this file is run after the environment is fully set up. We also have a clear mocks setting here that's set to true. And at the moment, we don't have any tests currently within the code base that uses any mocks, but mock calls or mock instances of any sort. But if there are in future, this ensures that we clear them on each test run. Also, we have the collect coverage from, and it's exactly that. So we just point to the location of where our main scripts are kept, and it will do a comparison and generate a coverage report based on that, which I'll show you in a bit. But this just references the location where our main scripts are kept. So most of them would ideally be kept within this site directory here. And as you can see, the sandbox.ts file is there. And the last one setting is the test environment. So by default, it uses Node.js, but because we're testing against the DOM with AEM and anything AEM at the moment, we have set this as JS DOM. So next, we would need a way to run these tests, and that's done within the package.json as Npm scripts. So we have a script here called test, and that effectively just runs Jest with a flag pass with no tests. And that's provided because if there aren't any tests, it will not fail. So we can do that now. So we can cd into the UI front end, and then we do npm test, and this will just run our test. There you go, that's done. The next one is test watch. So this is useful for a developer when writing tests. So if we run that, so if we just do test watch, and then we go to our test here, for example. Let's just go to the first one. So this asserts that we ensure that the component is available in the DOM. And that's done through the fixture here. Once the fixture is loaded, added as part of the inner HTML of the body, we can safely say that the component is added to the DOM. At the moment, the assertion is expects the container not to be null, so expects it to be on the page. If we remove the not, so this tries to assert that it's not null. It is null. Then it should fail, which it does, as you can see, and it did that in real time, so that's great. And back to the passing test. Yep, there you go, and it passes. So yeah, so that's the test watch. Not only does it watch for the test files, it also watches for the actual main script as well, so that's great. So the next one is the test coverage script. So the test coverage script will do the same, but we just pass in the coverage flag with that so that we can get a report on how many lines are covered, how many branches, how many functions, etc., etc. So we can do that with coverage here. Ideally, the coverage should be around 80% plus. As you can see, it's 100% here. This is you know, the perfect scenario, but it's probably unachievable as when we have a ton of scripts in the, across the site. So generally, I'd say if we aim for 80% or above, then that's pretty good. So yeah, as you can see, that we've got the coverage now, and we've got all the different ways to run the tests. But the main way, the main thing that we're after is running as part of the Maven build. So the Maven build picks up the prod script. I can show you that as part of the UI front end POM file. So as you can see here, npm run prod. So the goal is npm, the arguments passed in is run prod. So whenever we do run Maven build, it would run this script. And we've added the npm run test before any of our webpack concatenation and the actual build of the bundle. So what we can do, let's cd out of this. So we're in the main directory and we can run maven clean install, which triggers the maven build. And we can, if we look close to the, look closely on the output, we can see where exactly the test is run. So it does the npm install here. It's part of the front end UI front end module. And then here we go, just pass with no tests. And you can see that our tests are passing correctly. So this should continue on and succeed the build. And as you can see, we've got build success. Yay! So to prove that the build fails, we can do something similar to what we did previously. So remove the not. So we, at the moment, we expect the container to be null, which is not because it's added as part of the fixture. So let's run maven clean install again. And this time we should expect it to pass, sorry, fail. So let's do the test now. And yeah, we got a failure, which is exactly what we want. So when we have failing tests, it actually will break the build. So that's perfect. And concludes our demonstration. So thanks for watching. For further detail, please refer to the blog posts. And if there are any questions in the meantime, please drop us a line at 3share. We'll be more than happy to help you out. Thank you. Bye.